Cape Town, South Africa is inching closer now to day zero.
It's just 92 days away from having to shut off most water taps because of a severe drought.
To avoid the worst predicted effects of climate change, climate experts say we need to not only reduce our greenhouse gas emissions, but also remove and sequester carbon that's already been released in the atmosphere. To meet key climate targets, the world may need to directly capture as much as 600 million tons of CO2 per year, according to the International Energy Agency. There are more or less natural ways to do this. We can plant more trees, tweak farm soil to suck up more carbon, or spread green sand on beaches. Or we can pull carbon from the atmosphere using huge machines known as direct air capture or DAC technologies. Unlike forests, farms, or beaches, CO2 removal facilities aren't beholden to geographical constraints. The amount of carbon in the air is very similar across the planet, so we can establish them virtually anywhere. That's why the Swiss company Climeworks has opened the world's largest operational direct air capture plant in Iceland to suck carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere, with its Mammoth Plant almost 10 times larger than the current record holder. The Mammoth DSC plant, with 72 modular containers, has a capacity to capture 36,000 metric tons of CO2 a year. It is Climeworks' second commercial project, after the Orca plant, also in Iceland, which has a capacity of 4,000 tons a year and was previously the world's largest operational site. The carbon removal process is energy intensive, but Climeworks plants in Iceland are powered by the country's renewable geothermal power plants. Climeworks technology works by using fans to suck air into a collector container that is outfitted with filter material that absorbs CO2. The filter, also known as sorbent, is heated with steam to remove the carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is then separated out from the resulting mix of CO2, steam, and air, purified, dissolved in water, and then injected underground and mineralized, or essentially turned to stone for permanent storage. Outside, scientists confirmed that the Climeworks Orca project and an earlier pilot plant really do remove carbon, while producing very few emissions in a 2021 analysis published in Nature. Climeworks then sells offsets based on that captured carbon. It doesn't publicly say how much it charges its big corporate customers, including Microsoft, Shopify, and Stripe for the service, but it offers regular people carbon removal subscriptions at a price of $1,500 per metric ton of carbon removed. More than 20,000 people have signed up, according to the company's website. But carbon removal technologies such as DAC are still controversial. They have been criticized as expensive, energy-hungry, and unproven at scale. Some climate advocates are also concerned they could distract from policies to cut fossil fuels. Analysts estimate that for direct air capture to be widely adopted, the price of removing and storing 1 ton of carbon dioxide would have to fall to $100 by 2050. Today, it ranges from $600 to $1,000. ClimateWorks' Mammoth Plant also cost hundreds of millions of dollars to build, though the company didn't disclose the exact amount. The record-breaking Mammoth Plant may soon be dwarfed by much larger facilities set to open this decade. Next year, a subsidiary of the oil company Occidental Petroleum plans to open a plant in Texas capable of removing 500,000 metric tons of carbon per year, equivalent to emissions from 119,000 cars. Climeworks is designing another plant in Louisiana, it says, will capture 1 million tons of carbon annually by 2030. That's 238,000 cars. Experts say these early plants will play an important role in proving whether these machines work and just how expensive and energy-hungry they will be.